It's the Call Flow Radio Show, and you're on the air.
Call Flow Radio Show time here on WFLO AM 870. We're streaming online at WFLO.net and broadcasting this Tuesday morning from the Francis E. Wood Studio in downtown Farmville. I'm you're the consummate co-host. I'm just sort of here for the ride. John Staden and Noah Massard.
John Staden being the main host, and John, I'm sidecar in this show.
Consummate co-host.
Oh, okay.
There's something you can take for that when you're consummate. Anyway, what's the number again? 434-394-0924. Mm-hmm. If you'd like to be a part of this wonderful program.
Yeah.
So things happen. You know what didn't happen? That request. Do you remember we had the first time caller brought this up yesterday. I'll get into it. It was about the shooting at the power lines because of the birds. Heard about some more on that, but we'll put that on hold and take this caller and say good morning. You're on the air.
Good morning, fellas.
Hello, Henry.
How's everybody doing?
We're doing as well as can be expected. How are you?
I'm doing all right. We don't leave much left, but anyway. Yeah, doing okay. One day, I was talking to a friend of mine, and he had a glass eye. And he said one day he was going into Walmart, and he tripped on the door. As he went through the door, he tripped. And the eye popped out. And he said if it had hit the concrete floor, it would have cost $75,000 to get another one. But a young lady reached down and grabbed it and saved it. And she handed him back to her. And so I asked him, I said, well, when she handed you that, what did you say to her? He said, well, I asked her for a date, of course. And I said, why would you ask her for a date? He said, well, she just caught my eye.
That's a good one. I've heard it before, but it's always good.
Yeah, well, if you enjoyed it, I'll tell it again. But anyway.
Well, somebody out there may not have heard it. That's the way you got to think of it, right? There's always somebody hearing it for the first time.
Yeah, it's true, Again, I think I mentioned this, that Noah was going to get married, and the preacher said, do you, Noah? And he said, of course I know her. You don't think I'd marry a stranger.
That's going to be used at Noah's actual wedding, I'm sure.
Yes, John, it will be, actually.
Well, back.
And being the stand-up that he is and everything.
Back, everybody ready? back in the 1950s, Ned Johnson owned and operated a classy restaurant at Dowdy's Corner. Out there in the area, right there where that store is. And anyway, he was married to a French girl who was very beautiful. It was a nice restaurant, cloth tablecloths and red cloth napkins, and he made a lot of money. He bought a big farm, and anyway, things were going to look like extremely well. But then one day his wife disappeared, left. It said that she went back to France. Well, and suddenly, a couple months after that, Ned disappeared. And nobody really knew where he was. But 29 years later, I went to Lynchburg with Charlie Rosser, who managed Craddock Terry Shoe Company in Farmville. and they had a company meeting in Lynchburg, and he asked me to ride with him. So anyway, after the meeting around 9 o'clock, we stopped into a small restaurant to get a burger, and the rain was pouring down, and I looked out of the window and I saw a man staggering down an alley and going to a service station next door. And I recognized Ned Johnson. So after we ate, I went over there to see him, but he was gone. I couldn't find him. All right, move on up. A couple of years later, I was doing a gospel sing at Appomattox High School. At intermission, 20 people in the lobby, and I saw a man wearing an expensive suit working his way through the crowd towards me. And he finally got up there face to face, and he smiled and he said, "You don't know me." I said, "No, I don't, but I used to know you. But there's someone living in you today that wasn't there when I knew you." He smiled and he said, "I'm Ned Johnson." And he said, "I have listened to you for 29 years. And 2 years ago, you played a song. He did it all, and he did it all for me." And he said, "I fell down on my face and cried out to Jesus." And he said, "Ever since, everything I've touched has turned to gold." That song was by Lester Flatt and the Nashville Grass, and Bettie Jean Robinson sang the song. Mm-hmm. And anyway, when I got home after that gospel sing, I made a recording of this song and mailed it to him. 2 years later, we're having another sing there, and his wife, he had remarried, and his wife came up, and she says, "Well," she says, "Ned's no longer with us. He moved to heaven a while back." But that was a neat story of how one song could make such a difference.
True.
You know.
Indeed.
Really. Well, the Lord can use whatever.
That's right. Well, thank you, Henry.
Miracles happen every day.
Yes, sir. Thank you for sharing these stories with us.
Okay. Well, anybody wants to share something with me or have prayer or whatever, my number is 414-0096. And I hope to talk to you Thursday.
Hope so, Henry. You take care.
Thank you.
All right.
God bless.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, Henry Fulcher checking in this morning. So the phone lines are open if you'd like to call, 434-394-0924. So it looks like what we were talking about with the birds and mm-hmm. the
phone lines and the
power lines or whatever.
Lines.
Sounds like that where they were asking maybe not to do that, it happened anyway.
Did they shoot down like a power line?
Well, I don't know if they shot it down, but they affected. So there was outages. Supposedly in some areas. And I think it's the Bowery Boys myself. I don't think it's any hunters of any kind.
No,
no. It's probably young kids that don't know any better. But
yeah.
I think it's the Bowery Boys myself.
Mm. Well, where's that from, John?
Oh, I got it from the Farmville Herald.
No, the Bowery.
Oh, the Bowery Boys.
Yeah.
I don't even know if I'm saying it right, but let's just say there are very god-awful old black and white shorts that were made with the same kids, pretty much. They were boys. It's how would I describe this? It would be like the teenager boy angst version of the Little Rascals.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay, I get that.
It's sort of like that, yeah. But they're a little bit older than that. They'd be more like teenager age. And
almost like the Hardy Boys, but televised.
Kind of. Yeah, but it was like, I think they were like those things that used to run before movies or something like that, before an actual film. Mm-hmm. They were probably the shorts that they would run sometimes, I assume.
or maybe they were movies of, to themselves. I came across it through YouTube, and not because purposely. It was something that a certain channel would show movies, and every once in a while they'd show those kind of films. Mm-hmm. And I started to realize when those came on, I didn't like them very much, so I stopped watching. When I would see something with the Bowery Board or whatever they are called, I'd go, okay, we're not watching that tonight.
That's funny.
Yeah, because there was this one kid that's always in it, and he looks like he's 40-something years old playing a teenager, and he just irks me. So I'm just not a big fan. But anyway,
oh, man, that's funny.
Just not a fan. But anyway. Well,
that is a reference right there. That is deep in the archives.
I think it's the Bowery Boys.
Yeah.
But anyway, so.
Well, how many incidences of this happening are there?
Oh, I didn't read but delve into it too deeply. So
I mean, is it like one or two, or is it like five?
It just said, let's see. Where it's, I'm reading as see if I can get to the crust of what we're talking about here. The damage to the fiber network caused by birdshot is a reminder of the continued challenges we face. This would be a Firefly person, service manager Melissa Gay. However, I firmly believe that with our collective resilience and determination, we can turn the setback with an opportunity for education and growth. Can't really get into it because we do have another caller, so we'll take that now. Say good morning. You're on the air.
Top of the morning to you, fellas. How are you?
And the rest for myself.
All right, how are you?
Okay, all right.
What's going on?
Henry was talking about a song. I've got an earworm. I was making a quote-unquote mixtape. Now it's called a playlist, of course, you know. No
one. Right.
Mixtapes, but I was focusing on the 1980s, and I realized how many women-led bands there were in that era.
Right.
You know, women ruled the 80s, man. You know,
Pat
Benatar, Katrina and the Waves, Patti Smyth, and Scandal.
Yep.
And so I get to Blondie. And I didn't realize this, but she released a single in 1999. I guess she had a comeback in 1999.
Okay.
And the song is called Maria. And I don't know if you've heard this song, but for the last 2 days, I've woken up with this darn song in my head. And I just... It's like one of those songs where you end up playing it like 20 times a day, you know. It's weird, you know. You just can't get enough of it, but it just has everything in it, man. The guitar solo is short and sweet, you know, and the guitar rhythm's really, really good.
So how did you come across this song?
Searching through YouTube.
Okay.
And it's like Maria, what is this, you know? And so I added it to my tape, and it's like, oh man, you know, now, you know, everything's over now. You know, I can't get this song out of my head. You know.
Now, will you do that, and then eventually grow tired of it?
Yeah, right. Well, that's what I'm waiting for. It's like, come on, you know, please, you know.
I've been known to do that with songs. You know, you catch one you hadn't heard in a while or never have heard it before, and then you'll play it to death, basically, until you get tired of it.
Oh, right, yeah.
That one right off the bat, I don't recognize. I'd have to listen to it. So, Maria by Blondie. And you said it was 1999?
Yeah.
1999?
99?
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and it went to the top of the UK charts within like a week.
Wow. Yeah, the UK, for whatever reason, is a little more, or they used to be, I don't know now, a little more forgiving on people's ages in music, whereas the US, you know, as you well know, somewhere in the early to mid-90s, they put an edict down and we had to separate anybody that was over the age of, oh, I don't know, 30, 35 from the top 40 and relegated to the AC charts or whatever.
Or
country, even. They had to go country if they wanted to keep viable in the music business or something like that.
Right, yeah. Okay. All right, and Noah, have you come up with a DJ name yet?
Noah's Ark's not good enough?
Oh, man. No, I have not, sir. But I'm open to suggestions, so.
Come on. I know you've been thinking about it.
Maybe, I don't have anything. Sarge. I would actually, my last name is Massarge, so I would go by DJ Sarge. I think that's kind of
okay.
Funny.
All right. Well, DJ Sarge.
No, okay, I'm sorry. That's a bad one. You know what? Scratch that.
We're going to have military music every time you come on. Maybe a Gomer Pyle theme or something like that.
Yeah, right. Yeah, Noah.
Hey, Sergeant Carter. Shazam, Sergeant Carter.
No, you don't sound like any of the Sarges that I was involved with, I can tell you that.
Well, I'll take that as a compliment, I guess.
Yeah, okay. Yep. All righty. Okay, all right. I'm not sure when you have to go to spots, so I'm going to punch out, boys.
All right.
It was good talking to you.
Good talking to you. Have a good day.
Okay, you too. All right, bye.
Bye. Now, he told me something there I wasn't aware of with the whole Blondie song as late as 1999.
99. That's pretty crazy, yeah. I mean, I think I made him hang up.
Now, had you guys, had he asked you about a name thing before on a day where I wasn't here?
Yeah, I believe when me and Chris were on, we may have mentioned something about me, like having a DJ name. You
okay.
Know, how, like, you have your, like, shock, was it
my
little
dad,
gun?
No. My dad was shotgun.
That's right. So you're...
They used to kid me when I was a kid and call me Pop Gun, but then I had a name given to me when I was at another station. It was Jammin' John.
Okay.
But I didn't come up with it. The guy I worked with, he came up with it.
I'm glad you mentioned that, John, because I feel like nicknames, especially like DJ nicknames, they have to come from somebody else. You can't come up with your own. You can't be like, I want to be called blah, blah, blah. Well, it's definitely something that you earn.
It was more of a... I mean, it was more of a traditional type thing back in the day. I think my dad mainly did it because he was worked. By the time he went back into radio, he was John Staten initially in radio. And then when he went back, he was already doing – he had a full-time job, and he was just doing part-time radio on the weekends, like on a Sunday or something. And he came up with the nickname for that because back in those days, I don't know if moonlighting was still kind of – frowned upon in some sort of way or I don't know, but he based it off of another DJ that he had heard. I don't remember what the other guy's name was. Shotgun something, but a different name, and I think it popped in his head like at the last minute. He told me as he was getting ready to go on, he was trying to think of something to call himself other than his actual name. But yeah, I never gave the nickname a thought until I worked at that other station, and the guy I worked for, I think it was because I used to play music beds when I would talk, especially if I was voice tracking. I would always have a music bed up under me or something. Like because we used to have to read promo cards. You know, like we have the promos now that play. We had to read the promo cards when we were voice tracking. Wow. So I would, since you couldn't talk over music, but so much because... You know, just the way the intros might not be long enough or whatever, when you're having to read a card. So instead of just having nothing under me, I would play bed music up under me.
I got you.
Yeah. As I was talking. And I think that's where the name came from. He thought the music I was playing was up tempo and all this other stuff, which probably was. But anyway, how much time we got left?
Oh,
we
goodness,
got about less than 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Let's see. Looks like
did you want to finish the story about the?
Not really, because I don't want to sit here and read. That's,
okay, sure.
That's just not cool to read on the air. But I thought maybe I'd catch a little. It just looked like there must have been an incident of outages somewhere, maybe like over in Buckingham, Cumberland, like the more. Those places like that. But the gist of it was, it looked like that little. I wouldn't say warning, but the asking of maybe not doing that sort of thing didn't seem to be heeded, if you know what I mean.
I wonder if they could use forensic science to see who really did it.
Well, the woman actually said birdshot, so
that
there were signs of birdshot. So
hey.
But, I mean, I wouldn't put blame on anybody without any
knowledge of. I mean, that could have been anybody that did that. So, I mean, you know.
Could have been a 2-year-old.
Well, I wouldn't go that far. Let's Finsta, the baby that Bugs had a hard time with. Good morning. You're on the air.
Good morning, John.
Yo.
This is Dan.
Dan, how you doing?
Hey. I'm doing fine. How about you, guy?
Can't complain. Nobody would listen.
Hey, listen. The reason I'm calling, your last caller mentioned the girl bands.
Yes.
And he mentioned Pat Benatar.
Yep.
And I don't think a lot of people know this, but Pat Benatar actually got her start in Richmond.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
In the late 1970s, she was a cabaret singer at the Tobacco Company restaurant in downtown Richmond.
Right.
And that's how she got her start, and that's where she was discovered. Her husband at that time was actually in the Army stationed to Fort Lee. And that's where she would go down there and sing cabaret, basically, at the Tobacco Company.
I remember the Tobacco Company.
Well, they're still there.
I just remember, I remember the ads I used to hear for it on the radio all the time.
Yeah, yeah. And that, they were, the Tobacco Company was fairly new then, and she started there. That was in the late 70s when she did that. But I thought that was, you know, a cabaret singer from there to, you know, Pat Benatar, the rock and roller.
Well, that happens.
And a new husband after that. But
it was like Kenny Rogers. He went reverse. He started to be in rock, and then he ended up being a country star.
In country, Kenny Rogers in the first edition.
Yep.
I remember.
What condition is my condition?
But anyway, the guy mentioned the girl bands, the women bands in the 80s, but, you know, she got her start there in Richmond, and that's kind of a local thing, and I wanted people to know that. I thought it was pretty interesting.
That's cool.
Yeah.
If I knew that, I forgot about it.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I know you're coming up to the bottom of the hour. I just wanted to say hello and pass along that little bit of trivial information.
Well, thank you, Dan. Are you doing all right?
I'm doing okay, John.
Good. Yeah. Well, thanks.
Yeah, I'll stop by and see you guys one day.
Please do, and call back anytime.
Will do. Thanks a lot, guys.
All right, take care. Yeah,
bye-bye.
Bye. Dan Albus, who has helped us.
A little nugget of history. Like, I mean, I didn't know that. Pat Benatar.
He may have told me that one time before, because once he mentioned it, It started to sink in that I had heard that before, but yep, Pat Benatar. There was a lot, like the other caller he mentioned. There was a lot of ladies,
female led bands
leading. And I could, you know, well, Heart actually started in the 70s, late 70s, but they were a powerhouse in the 80s.
Yeah,
and. I'm trying to, you know, I can't right now. Joan Jett.
Mm-hmm.
You could go with Joan Jett. He may have mentioned Joan Jett, the other caller.
I think he did.
But, yeah, you know, just people like that. Pat Benatar was always kind of a mainstay, especially on MTV in the early 80s. You saw her everywhere. It's interesting to go back and think about that sort of thing. And now, what's funny is I wasn't too much into those female
rock
singers.
That is hilarious, Jenna.
When I was a younger person, when I was a kid,
It
took me a while. But once I got over that or whatever, or evolved, whatever you want to call it, I started to realize that there are a lot of great female singers.
Do you like the Joan Jett type with the more raspy kind of like, you know, kind of voice?
I thought when I was a kid, I thought Joan Jett was cute.
Yeah.
Because she had that really dark hair and she had those big dark eyes. And I just, I mean, I, you know, and she rocked. I mean, she was kind of like Pat Benatar. She rocked, but Pat Benatar, to me, visually looking at her, she was a smaller frame lady. Mm-hmm. And, I don't know. Yeah. Joan Jett, I started to realize, was maybe a little more punk than the others, a little bit more. She played guitar. I didn't realize until I discovered that she had been in the Runaways before, and she had been with her with another female that caught on. Now the name is escaping me, but The 80s was an interesting time in music, because if you were listening to just regular top 40 radio, you still heard different genres of music. You heard rock, you heard more pop type stuff, and then you heard, you know, maybe a little bit of country if it was a crossover. It's kind of gotten back to that a little bit, but rock doesn't seem to be existent in the top 40, but so much these days. But But back in those days, it did. But anyway, we're at the bottom of the hour, so we need to move along here.
Okie dokie.
All right, so we'll do the weather real quick, and then that'll make way for you to do your birthdays. And so for today, sunny skies, a high near 82, clear tonight with a low around 53. Sunny Wednesday, a high near 83, mostly clear Wednesday night with a low around 55. Thursday, mostly sunny, a high near 81, and Thursday night, mostly cloudy with a low around 59. Humidity, 96%, winds calm, barometer 30.15, and right now in Farmville, we've got fair skies 51. And now the birthday calendar, brought to you by Creative Electrical Contractors, located at 1907 East 3rd Street, Farmville. Where did it go? Did we already play it?
I don't know. Let me...
It is not where I normally see it. Interesting. I don't know. We'll see if we can pull this up here. This is live radio.
Yes. Well, I mean, yes. It is live, and it is happening.
Yeah, for some odd reason. But here we go. I think I found it.
Creative Electrical Contractors specializes in commercial and industrial projects and offers quality work at competitive prices. CEC is a licensed Class A contractor in Virginia and North Carolina. Creative Electrical Contractors has been in business for 25 years, still committed to the values that were established when the company opened in 1998. Integrity, quality workmanship, and timely delivery. CEC, located at 1907 East 3rd Street, Farmville. You can contact CEC at 434-392-3802. Or at creative-electrical.com.
All right, and with those birthdays and possible anniversaries, I present to you Noah Massage, the Sarge. That's a name for you, the Sarge.
The Sarge?
The Sarge. And we say it like that, and then that'll work.
The Sarge.
The Sarge.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, we got some birthdays. Also, by the way, I like how you say, I present to you, like I'm just like a sideshow act, that I'm like, hey, here's the birthdays.
You're picking up on what I'm putting down, aren't you?
Of course, all right, John. Okay, John. All right, okay. Janet Hunter is celebrating today. We also have Francis Redford. I don't think he's related to Robert Redford, but maybe. Carrie G. Neithery, Melody Neithery, so that's in the same family. Turtle Dylan.
Turtle?
That's the name. I'm all looking right at it. Turtle Dylan. Tim Murphy. We also have celebrating an anniversary today. Ronnie K. Bahan and Cody and Tiffany Toombs. So that's some two anniversaries and a whole lot of birthdays for you. John, back to you.
Whole lot of birthdays going on. All right. So if you would like to add, include, take away, whatever the case may be, give us a call, 434-394-0924, or how else could they send us birthdays?
Yes, John, so they can send those birthdays to birthdays@wflow.net, and we can go ahead and get them from there, too.
The birthday calendar brought to you by Creative Electrical Contractors. If it is not right, we will make it right. Call 434-392-2802. And you got about 15 some odd seconds left.
Wow.
Dun, dun, dun.
It's your birthday with Noah the Sarge.
It's like a Popeye thing going on, John. That's like Popeye. Yeah.
Okay. And there you go.
All right.
You know what we haven't done that you always love to do so much?
What is that, John?
That would be on this day in history.
Oddities. No, didn't we do that in the beginning?
Not because I would have known this. We talked about this. 1608 is going back. John Smith, chosen president of Jamestown.
Wow.
Are you aware of
John Smith? John Smith? Yes, I am.
Having survived capture by Indians, reputedly through the efforts of Pocahontas, a chief's daughter. That chief would be Chief Powhatan, by the way. That's what being a local Virginian will get you. You know your Virginia history somewhat. John Smith became president of Jamestown Colony, the first permanent English settlement in North America, this day in 1608.
Yeah.
And then, but she wound up with John Rolfe. So explain that one to me.
Yeah.
All right, let's take this caller. Good morning. You're on the air.
Good morning. Thank you for going back to the jazz birthday music. That stuff you put on there last week was awful.
That's to annoy
the Sarge over here.
It is to annoy me and to make me more irritable than I'm already. And just at base level. No. I would have to agree with the caller, though, John. That music is horrible.
Hence, we'll keep doing it every once in a while, then.
No.
Anything else you'd like to talk about?
No, it's not the only one that didn't like it. Chris said last week she didn't like it.
She didn't like it? Okay. You're still not giving me any reason to stop doing it, though. I'm starting to really feel like I'm in the right direction. That it was a goof, I will admit that. That's the whole reason I put it in, was to goof off.
Mm-hmm. Do you like it, John?
Oh, yeah. No, I don't. No, it doesn't bother me one way or the other. I just did it just to get a rise out of Noah.
Yep. And he sure did. He sure did.
We loved the jazz one so much, the one we just played. Yeah. I was like, well, I'm gonna throw him a curveball here and see how he reacts to this one.
And he didn't even say what's gonna happen. It was a little surprise.
Tragedy? Is that what you said?
Yeah. No, it's 49ers.
Oh, the 49ers. I saw that game that they were gonna be playing. I don't know. I have a weird thing with I won't watch football games until it's playoffs, and then that's when I really start tuning in. I guess I've spent too many games watching it, like watching games, but when it didn't really matter a whole lot, and then I always ended up disappointed. I don't know. I think for
the 49ers made the Super Bowl last year, so you had plenty of playoffs to watch.
I did, yeah. That is true. That is true. Yeah.
Now, John's favorite show is on tonight. There's a date.
Could you speak up a little bit, please?
Yeah. John, your favorite show comes on tonight. The debate.
The debate.
Oh, the debate.
Yeah.
Are you going to watch that?
Probably not.
Probably not. Okay, I was thinking about watching it, but just to see how they handle it. That doesn't mean I'll stick with the whole thing. I might just watch a few minutes of it.
They're kind of entertaining.
I'm sorry.
They're kind of entertaining a little bit. You know.
Yeah.
They're kind of entertaining.
Yeah. Well, they can be. I thought the last one was.
The last one was very entertaining in the sense that,
I mean,
wow.
I will say this: Trump did not go for the jugular in that. He could have, but he didn't. He just let somebody just melt right there in front of everyone else.
Also, weirdly enough, insult his golfing skills as well. Biden's golfing skills during the debate.
I don't remember that. All I remember is when he said something about, "Yeah, we killed Medicare." Yeah. He could have really, really gone in for the jugular, and he didn't do it.
There was a part where Donald was like, I just competed in a golf competition last week. I came in first place. There's 40-year-olds.
Oh, there. I thought you were saying cough.
No, golf. Oh, okay. Golf competition.
Okay.
And then,
okay, Sarge.
All right, John. But
Sarge.
Anyways. And then he was like, do you think this guy over here could do that? No. No way.
Well, he
and then Biden is just like kind of like slumped over.
I bet you can't carry your bags. I bet you can't.
It's pretty young.
Yeah, tough guy. Mr. Tough Guy Biden there. He's a tough dude. But, you know, anyway. So, all right, so you're not going to watch the debate. So, is there anything? So, you watched the football game last night, I take it.
Yes, I did.
Were you rooting for the 49ers?
Yes.
Well, you're happy because they won, right?
Yeah, I don't like Aaron Rodgers, the quarterback for the Jets.
Oh, did he play?
Yes.
He did play for the Jets, okay.
But he didn't do good at all.
Didn't
he
do good.
He retired.
Well, yeah. It's, you know what's really sad is I remember when he was a rookie backing up Brett Favre.
Brett Favre. Yeah.
Played in a Cowboys game, and they were beating Favre
And then Favre either got pulled or he got knocked out of the game. And then that guy came in, Aaron Rodgers, and he almost came back. Mm. He may have. I used to back when Emmitt Smith used to play, and Troy Aikman and Michael Irvin, back when they were good, and Jimmy Johnson was the coach. But that was back like when I was in high school.
Jimmy was calling the game last night.
What was that?
Troy Aikman was calling the game last night.
Yeah, he was. Let's see. And now you got Tom Brady. That's, what do you think of him and his announcing skills these days?
Because
I think this was his first year. I don't think he's calling games, but they got him on the Fox lineup of the announcers. Is there any way you could speak up a little louder, sir?
Yeah. Did they ever have you fill in and, like, have you calling Hampton Sydney football or anything like that?
Thank goodness, no. No, I never did that. I board opt games, meaning I'd be here at the board and I would, you know, put it on and play commercials, which is also not that wonderful, but at least it's better than doing the announcing. No, I never called a football game. Closest I ever did anything like that was when I was in high school and I would do the starting lineup for our basketball team just before they played. But that's really as far as my sports career announcing went.
Oh, so they had you do the lineup. Do you remember how to do it?
Yeah, they'd give me the starting lineup list, and I actually had a cassette with me. There you go. That's going back. And I had the music to, let's see, it was Alan Parsons Project. And it's the intro to a song, and it usually gets taken out on radio. They go straight to the song. They don't play the intro. And I want to say it was Sirius. Yep, the Alan Parsons Project, 1982. So I'll play you a little bit of it, and you will get a feel of kind of what I did. I'll have to make up the names because I don't remember the names I did back then, but here we go. So the music would start up. And the reason I used this music was there was, back in the day, the playoffs between the Phoenix Suns and the Chicago Bulls. And when the Phoenix Suns would come out, this is what would play, this music right here. And then they would go, and now your starting lineup for the Phoenix Suns. And then I'd get really into it, and I'd go, at forward, blah, 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 whatever his name is, Joe Smith, center. And then I would give them, they asked me to give them nicknames. So I would sit there and come up with nicknames on the playmaker, power forward, James Worthington, you know, whatever, I don't know. But that was what we used to do.
Playmaker?
I got that from Michael Irvin. I was just stealing names from other, you know, people. But yeah, that's, so anyway, that's enough of that. But that's what we used to do. So, I need to kill this bed. All right, there we go. So that's about as close as I ever got. Hello?
He's not.
The first time I've heard that.
You have heard that before?
Yes.
Yeah.
Somewhere.
Yeah, I always thought that intro was always kind of cool.
It is cool.
Play that for the birthday music one day.
What's that?
Play that for the birthday music one morning.
What about the birthday music?
Use that as the birthday music.
Oh,
use that as the birthday music. Wouldn't that be cool?
John, do you want to try it?
Sure, one.
Okay. All right. Let me just signal me when you're ready.
When it starts going, ding, 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 ding.
Okay. Today, we have Janet Hunter.
You gotta get into it.
Okay.
And now,
and
the
now
birthday.
Janet Hunter.
Yeah, there you go.
Frances Redford. Carrie G. Neithery.
Yeah.
Melody Neithery.
Right.
Turtle Dylan.
Turtle!
Tim Murphy.
Yeah.
That's it.
Okay.
And those were the birthdays.
And the birthdays.
For today.
Send them to. It does change the mood of
it
the
does.
Birthdays.
It does. Like, it gets you pumped up. him. Yeah. That's what it's meant to do. It's meant to get you pumped up, the crowd pumped up. Yeah.
Anyway. Oh, man. Anyways, John, that was fun and wild. And
it's a trip down memory lane for me. Anyway.
No one can impersonate John yet.
Can you impersonate me yet?
Oh, can I impersonate?
Yeah.
Hello? How's it going? Yeah,
that's what I say all the time. Wow. Hello, how's it going?
No, but I think I'm working on your cadence, John. I'm working. It's a slow look. It's a piece of the puzzle. It's a big puzzle. I'm trying to put it all together. I think a lot of impersonating John is impersonating his posture, and then the voice kind of comes out on its own.
Okay, so this is what we do here. Okay?
That's there you go. Not even close. Like, I want it to be good, but it's not. Unfortunately.
Now, let's do this very quietly, okay?
You're doing that. I'm, for some reason, my Noah's turned into Richard Simmons and Daffy Duck and
suffering fuck its head.
Yeah.
A couple weeks ago, when nobody was calling in, and
nobody, do you speak up, sir? I think we lost you.
Nobody was calling in. That was hilarious. We know we're picking on each other like 2 weeks ago.
What was hilarious?
When y'all were picking on each other a couple weeks ago.
Picking on each other a couple weeks ago.
Oh, goodness. That was, yeah.
I thought that was every day. I mean, yeah.
Sometimes.
And I remember, I think one person called and said that they were listening, and I was going to do that. And I thought, you know, I'm enjoying this so much, laughing so hard, I'm not going to call in.
Oh, my God. That's so funny.
Yeah, no one's telling John if he's not running the board correctly, and John's like, hey, I'm going to radio longer. I know how to do this. Y'all was like, yeah, okay, prove it.
I think I know what it is. Something about I was on the board, and Noah said something about he can run the board, and I said, go ahead and prove it, or something like that. Is that what you said?
Yeah, you did. You totally proved it.
Okay, well, that sounds like something I would
do. It's a classic moment. That's a nice bickering back and forth kind of, you know.
I'm a big believer in anyone that tells me they can do something better. I'm a big believer in moving out the way and going, okay, prove it. Show me. I'm a big believer in that sort of thing. It's a great philosophy.
I'm really going to play that.
Play that what?
Alan Parsons.
I might sneak it in, everyone. I might mislabel it. That's always a fun trick to play on jocks, is put something and mislabel it as something else, and then they hit it and go, wait a minute.
That's not it.
That's not it.
John.
The day that y'all were picking on each other, we played
any of the match game. Well, match game.
Yeah.
Played the bed to match game. I remember that. Yeah. Yep. Yeah.
And then there were some other theme song that you played, and no one was talking, and you turned up the theme song to the two of them.
I remember this caller. Thank you for bringing that up, because I... And I was going to let that go, but you saying it really... really makes me remember how...
We were having problems with Noah's mic that day, if
we
I recall.
We were having a couple of problems with the mic that day, John.
What was that again?
No one said that he couldn't hear himself, and you told him that his mic was working, but you'd be happy to turn it off.
Classic John.
Yeah, well, yeah. That's why they pay me the big bucks.
That's right. John, just a future note. Next time we start getting in a fight and I don't realize it, just start playing, just like slowly.
Want me to put this seriously?
Yeah, just slowly just put that up and just like make it fade into where I don't notice it until we're like halfway through the song.
As I pot that up, I pot you down.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you. Anything else you'd like to add before we go? What was that again?
Spotlight? Yes. Yes.
Do you already have something planned out for that?
John Gunther, that one's been released. That was last...
I'm referring to your next one. Do you have somebody planned for the next one?
I do have somebody in the works right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good. Well, do you enjoy that?
Pretty good.
Okay, good. What was that again?
Have you ever listened to it, John?
Oh, have you ever listened to it, John?
I have.
Yeah, have you?
Yeah, I have, because it interrupts when I'm on. Yeah, I was supposed to be on, and they just like shucked me off to the side. I was driving home, and I was supposed to be hearing myself, and I didn't.
No, John, that's not true.
No, it's okay. I got over it.
John, you're making it. No. Munjo.
Yeah, I had to answer you. Yeah, yes, I've listened to it.
He's listened to it.
Because he was sorely disappointed that the other guy, he didn't play as much music as he thought he was going to.
Oh, that's not true at all. I think he played, it was just enough.
I wish he had played more.
Oh. Oh, okay.
I was hoping he would.
It would have been nice. He
anybody with that talent should play more than...
I don't think he wanted to wear out his welcome.
That's okay.
But yeah.
Well, thank you, sir, for calling in. You call back anytime. Have a good one, all right?
Oh, I'll do that. Yeah.
Thank you.
All right, well, thanks for listening.
Yeah, no problem.
All right, take care.
Bye.
All right.
John, I do need to mention that for Heart of Virginia, we will be out there. We're going to have a table, and we also have a grand surprise.
The big wheel.
Yes. Well, no.
No, that's my grand surprise.
No, John, we have a huge...
Are you dressing up as someone? Are you going to divulge this information?
No. What are you talking?
Because I know it's not going to be me, because I'm going to be spinning a wheel.
No, John.
I am Vanna White, spinning a wheel.
It's not what you think. I should have mentioned this before.
Oh, good.
It's not what you think, but it is a big surprise, so... Just letting you know.
You're dressing as Smokey the Bear. Is that what it is?
Now you spoiled it for everybody, John. Come on.
Only you can prevent forest fires.
Yeah, but we will be there, and we'll have our own table. So make sure, we're still waiting to get our spot, but our location, I should say.
Do you know where the location is?
We don't know quite yet, but as soon as we find that out, we'll let everybody know. But just keep an eye out.
You let me know, and I might show up.
All right. Okay.
Hey, you know what we didn't do? We didn't do celebrity birthdays.
Is your favorite part.
But did you watch The X-Files at all?
I love The X-Files.
1993 TV series, The X-Files, starring David Duchovny, Gillian Anderson, debuted on this day in 1993 on Fox. Developed a huge cult following.
Yeah.
So you were a fan of that?
Yeah. I mean, just recently I started really getting into it. But I always was aware of it, like it being a show, kind of spooky. But I'm a huge fan of it, and also it's kind of funny the Simpsons reference it a surprising amount, I guess, because they both came out on Fox around the same time.
Simpsons would have preempted it. I mean, as far as before them,
that's correct.
At least by a couple of years.
I think the Simpsons came out in like 89,
something like
88.
All right, let's take another caller. Good morning. You're on the air.
Oh, good morning. This is the Jam and John and Shane with Shalom show.
You got it.
Oh, great. I know I only got a minute or two. Yeah, but,
go ahead.
Did you hear that James Earl Jones died?
Is that why I saw his picture? Let me pull it up.
And
I was afraid of that when I saw it.
And here's something interesting. I was listening to the Baltimore station this morning.
Yeah.
And they were talking that he did the national anthem at the, I think it was the 93 O's game.
Okay, I wasn't aware of that. Yeah.
I wasn't either.
I saw the picture this morning, and I didn't bother to look at the headline, but yeah, it passed away at 93. That's a shame.
And, I was curious as to how it sounded. Evidently, he had a choir or something behind him, and he almost, you know how he talks.
Oh, yeah.
So I guess it was something similar to that kind of
It was probably,
talking.
Spoken, recitation type thing. Yep.
Yeah.
James Earl Jones. Now, he actually was in a movie where he was the villain, and I don't mean Star Wars. I mean Conan the Barbarian. He was Thulsa Doom against Arnold Schwarzenegger, if you ever saw that one.
Yes, I did. Yeah, man.
So you had the voice and his actual face when you were. He was good in that. He plays a good bad guy for sure.
I agree. Yes.
Well, thank you for letting us know about that, because, like I said, I saw the picture. I hadn't really had a chance to pull it up yet, but thanks for mentioning that.
Yeah, you're welcome. And it's National TV Dinner Day.
Do you still eat TV dinners?
Oh, my gosh, no. But I was when I was a kid, we thought that was the biggest treat.
Right. Oh, I remember. Then you actually eat it and go, what was so great about that?
Oh, my gosh, and we had those little fold-out tables sitting under the television.
I remember.
Oh, man.
I remember.
Like eating at the Ritz. But I snuck out that you guys have a booth. I think it's in one of the alleys.
Probably so. It's where we need to be.
Near a dumpster?
Yeah, that'd be good.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. I'm sorry to waste your time.
No. But, you were the one that brought up the fact that they were shooting at the power lines. Did you come across that from the paper, or how did you hear about that?
Yeah, I saw it in the papers.
Okay.
The papers. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yep. And there was an actual outage occurrence because of it, right?
Oh, my God. I just kind of read, sometimes if it doesn't sound interesting, I just read, like, the first opening paragraph or two.
Okay.
And then I'll continue.
Mm-hmm.
But I bet you somebody was hauling butt after they found out.
Probably.
So, hiding everything.
Well, anything else you wanted to talk about?
No, you know what? We should have a fundraiser for the gentleman before me. And get him a new phone.
Yes.
Sounding rude to you out there, man. But yeah.
Well, I think his phone works, but I think he puts us on some sort of speaker phone or something. I don't know what it is. I'm just speculating.
First time caller, can you understand him though when you're listening to the radio?
I can. The only thing I can understand is you guys saying, "What did you
Responding.
Say?" I'm sorry, can you repeat that?
Okay.
Yeah. It really is challenging out here in Radio Land to understand them.
It's a rough signal, caller. Don't get discouraged. Just even a flip phone might be better. I know you're calling from a potato.
I know a tin can with a string. Mm-hmm. You got the string running through your station, but it's all just part of AM radio, so mm-hmm.
True.
Yeah, I don't mind. So
all right, well, but, thank you, and we'll talk at you next time, I guess. It'll be Chris Sarge tomorrow and the next day.
All right, okay.
The Sarge will be in.
Yeah. Unless if you want John in, then
we got to have the Sarge.
I mean, we can get John in. I can.
He marches to his own beat. Well, have a great day, and we'll talk at you next time.
Thank you kindly.
All right, take care.
All right, bye. Goodbye.
All right, that's the Call Flow Radio Show. Anything else you'd like to add with Sarge?
Nope. No, I think we got all the ground covered. A lot of calls today. This was a good day.
It was busy.
I hope to hear from all of you again tomorrow with me and Chris. And John, I hope you can come in too.
I'm going to mention 1955 TV show Gunsmoke began airing on CBS on this day. And by the time it ended in 75, the series was at that time was the longest running Western TV American television program.
Incredible.
Gunsmoke. Well, it's for men, so it's okay. Yeah. But anyway, you guys have a great show tomorrow, and I might listen in. Have a good one. Bye.